I received one message that completed. So, okay, yeah, multiple messages starts to receive. So we'll proceed. Thanks for everyone. We'll proceed to the next chapter now. Just a minute. Okay, thank you everyone for replying me. So we'll go to the next chapter, unit number 2. Okay. Now you understood from where you are supposed to collect the water for requirement and what kind of analysis you are supposed to do in a for the water. Okay, here in the last part, that water quality parameters, characteristic and their significance, drinking water quality standards. So water quality parameters, why we should understand? Because this is a raw water from the river, from the open source. And it may be a dirty, not maybe, it is dirty usually. There are the different impurities present into the water when it is in a open form. Or if it is in the groundwater, there also there are the different types of impurities. So the different impurities will be present into the surface water and different impurities will be present into the groundwater. Okay, so that's why according to the source, we need to understand what are the exact impurities are present into the wastewater, into the water. Then only we will be able to provide the treatment process. Means whenever we go to doctor, what we do, we are explaining what is happening with you, what wrong you are is happening with you. You are not feeling well, you are feeling temperature, you are feeling headache, you are feeling nausea. Accordingly, they are understanding what are the impurities present in your body and then they are giving treatment. So same here, we are providing So we are going to understand what are the parameters, what are the impurities are present into the water, and accordingly we can provide the, we can decide what kind of treatment are required. Okay, so that's why the fundamental part we should understand in a unit number one. Now once you understood the quality of water and the demand of water for the particular society, you can go for the treatment. Okay, now the treatment process, again it is going to be classified into primary treatment, secondary treatment and tertiary treatment. Okay, so for your syllabus here, almost a primary and secondary treatment you are going to study. The tertiary treatment, some part we are going to study. Okay, so the first of all, unit number two, the title of unit is the primary treatment units. Then what under that, what we are going to study? Water treatment. Sorry guys, there was a disturbance, there was a phone call and so it was disconnected. So water treatment, what we are going to study under this chapter, the first chapter, sorry, second chapter we are going to study, and that chapter is the primary treatment units. Water treatment, first part, principles of water treatment, operations and processes. Water treatment flow sheets, aeration. Under aeration, we are going to study principle and concepts, necessary methods, removal of taste and odor. Then sedimentation, plain and chemical assisted principle, efficiency of an idle settling basin, settling velocity, types of sedimentation tanks, design of sedimentation tanks, introduction and design of tube settler. Then coagulation and flocculation, principle of coagulation, common coagulants, alum and ferric salts, introduction to other coagulants, coagulant aids like bitumen, clay, then limestone silicates, polyelectrolytes, introduction to natural coagulants, then the concept of flocculation chamber, then the design of clary flocculator. So this part we are going to study. So I will explain in a short here that water treatment, it is going to be classified into primary, secondary and tertiary. So what includes in a primary treatment process? In a primary treatment, this much part. Okay, what is the first unit operation? Usually this aeration is the first unit operation. Then sedimentation tank, there are the different types of sedimentation tanks. What are the different types of sedimentation tank? Plain sedimentation, sedimentation with coagulation, rectangular sedimentation, then sedimentation with coagulation. Okay, so these are the different part. Then sedimentation with tube settler, sedimentation with plate settler. So there are the different types of sedimentation we are going to study over here in this point. Number sedimentation. Sedimentation in the sense settling of the settleable particle. Ekada glass ghetla apan, glass madhe agodar ek pani ghetla thoda same eka beaker madhe ani tyachyamadhe thodi shi mati takli. Okay, so that and then we will stir that water and soil together, and then we will allow to settle it. Okay, we will keep it aside. After some time whatever the settleable impurity is present into that, it will start settling down. Barabar hai? That depends upon the mass and size of the each individual particle present into that. But the non-settleable particles are also present into that water, which may not be able to seen by us by naked eyes, and these will remain into the water. Okay, so this is the sedimentation. Then the second chapter is the coagulation and flocculation. In the coagulation and flocculation means, as just now I have given to you example that beaker we have kept for the settling purpose. Whatever the settleable particles present into that water will settle down at the bottom, and remaining impurities, that impurities are usually known as the suspended impurities, will remain in a water. Okay, now for the removal of such types of impurities, we need to add some agents, and these agents are usually known as the coagulants. And when you are applying coagulants like the bituminate clay, then lime, then polyelectrolytes, then some natural coagulants like the moringa seed, okay, then alum is there. So such a coagulant, when you apply to the water, they will start neutralizing the charge present on the individual particle, and because of the neutralization of that charge, it will start coming together. Multiple impurities, multiple individual particles will start coming together, and hence this will start converting into the heavy mass. Once it starts converting into the heavy mass, automatically it will start settling down at the bottom, and that process is known as the sedimentation. With coagulation, mix the with the water properly, okay, and that is also known as the clarifloculator. So that design of the clarifloculator also we are going to study in this chapter. So you are going to study about the primary units. What are the primary units? Basically aeration and sedimentation, simply you can say. Again, it is going to be this explained in detail when we are going to study the chapter. So write down the unit number 2 syllabus, primary treatment units. Once you're done, please keep on dropping the message so I can proceed to the next chapter. Sanket dropped a message completed. With the others, all others have completed or yet to be completed?
No, ma'am.
Okay, many of them are many of you are replying that completed. So well, I will assume that everybody has completed. And I will proceed. Okay. Thank you everyone for replying me. Shall we proceed? Okay, if someone remain, they can copy from this upper portion. So the unit number 3, as I told you, after primary treatment, we are supposed to send that treated water from the primary treatment to secondary treatment units. What includes in the secondary treatment units? First is the filtration. Filtration unit will be there. Under filtration, we are going to study theory of filtration, mechanism of filtration, then filter materials, types, rapid, gravity, pressure, filter, multimedia and dual filter media, components, then under drainage systems, then working and cleaning of filter, then operational troubles, design of rapid and gravity filters. Okay, so the under filtration you are going to study what is the exact phenomena, on which basis, on which principle basis the filtration process occurs. So there are the different types of filter, rapid sand filter, gravity filter, then pressure filter, multimedia filter, dual media filter. And these different Slosan filter is also there, but it is removed from your syllabus. Okay. Then components under drainage system, working and cleaning of filter, and operational troubles, design of rapid and gravity filter. Okay, this much part we are going to study under the filtration process itself. Then the disinfection mechanisms, then excuse me guys for one sec. Bola sir. Sorry, I'm back now. Then what are the different troubles we are facing while filtration process, and then what should be the design for the as per the requirement, as per the demand, and as per the excellence of water we required, we are going to study under the filtration point. Okay, then the disinfection after filtration, there is usually the disinfection process where we are making the mechanism to kill the bacteria. Okay, by using the disinfectant. So there are the different disinfectants, but usually the chlorine is effective one disinfectant. So chlorine as a disinfectant we can apply in the form of solid, in the form of liquid, as well as in the form of gas, as per the required. And as per the degree of excellence for the treatment of water, we can decide which method we are going to study in mechanics. Then factors affecting disinfection, then types of disinfections, then types and methods of chlorination, then breakpoint chlorination, bleaching powder chlorination. Okay. So how the disinfection performs, what exactly phenomena performs, we are going to study in the part disinfection point. Then demineralization methods. Under the demineralization method, there is a lime soda, ion exchange, reverse osmosis. I think for the first year engineering under the subject chemistry, some part you have. Let me check what is that message. Sound problem. काय होते?
Sound problem
म्हणजे प्रतीक काय अडचण येते?
मॅम साउंड
क्रॅक होते.
क्रॅक होते?
हा मॅम.
Voice is breaking. Everybody is writing. Let me check network. Network is fine. Then now how is sound now?
Now clear.
Maybe my that it is clear now. Maybe that it is rubbing to the table and then it is disconnecting. Okay, I will take care. Okay, now disinfection, I was telling you we are killing the bacteria by using the different disinfectants. Maybe the disinfectant chlorine or the bleaching powder or some other disinfectants we can use, that chlorinated copperous material, ferric sulfate, etc. But the usually that is effective disinfectant is the chlorine one. Okay. Then the demineralization method, as this part, I think some part of this point of you have studied in the chemistry subject in the first year. but still we are going to study in detail. These are the little advanced methods for the treatment of water for the removal of minor impurities present into the wastewater, present into the water. So in that we are going to study lime soda process, ion exchange method, then reverse osmosis method, then ultrafiltration and electrodialysis. Okay, these are the four different methods for the demineralization, means minerals we are removing from the water with the help of excess amount of minerals are harmful to the health. It should be present, but up to the certain limit, and each individual is having there is a certain limit. So for making them to the certain limit, we can go for the demineralization process. Not required to go for all these methods together in a sequence. Either of these methods we can use for the treatment or for the removal of minerals from the water. Either lime soda, either ion exchange, either reverse osmosis, or the ultrafiltration and electrodialysis method. Then fluoridization and defluoridization. In the fluoridation, what we do, addition of fluoride particles. Up to some extent, requirement of fluoride is there. And then defluoridization, if there is an excess fluoride, it affects on the human health, then how to remove it. So that concept you are going to study under the point defluoridation and defluoridization. Okay. This is the syllabus we are going to study about under the chapter unit number 3, secondary treatment units. Okay. So I request you to copy the syllabus. I will drink the water. Okay, I think started receiving the messages that you have completed. Give me 1 minute, just one work, and then we'll continue to the section 2. Just 1 minute, guys. Okay, we'll proceed now. Am I audible properly?
Yes, ma'am.
Section 2. Yeah, thank you. Section 2. Now, in the section 1, what we studied about where, from where and how to collect the water, then how to do the analysis of the primary, how to do the analysis or how to find out what are the impurities present into the water before entering it into the treatment plant. Okay, then once it is entered into the treatment plant, there we are studying how to give the primary treatment process and remove the impurities, then how to go for the secondary treatment to remove the remaining impurities present into water. Is it up to this part we have studied into the section 1. Now section 2 belongs to how to transport the water and from treatment plant to consumer points. Okay, in the section 2, the next unit, the name of unit number 4, conveyance of water. In that conveyance of water, what we are going to study, transmission of water, pumping and gravity mains, choice of pipe materials, stresses in pipes, economic size of pumping main, then distribution reservoir, service storage, necessity, location, design, head and capacity requirements. Okay, so here in a conveyance of water, how to transport the water from water treatment plant towards the consumer points we are going to study. Transmission of water, understood? Then pumping and gravity mains. Some of the part you have studied in a fluid mechanics. Is it IFM subject, introduction to fluid mechanics subject, in that you have studied about some of the syllabus. Then transmission of water, pumping and gravity mains, then what type of pipe material should be selected for the collection or the transportation of water, because pipe material matters to change the properties of water. Also, the pipe material, in respect of pipe material, we need to take care that because of the quality, because of the various parameters present into the water, may change the properties of pipe material and may weaken the pipe material. Okay, so that's why we need to study the choices of pipe materials. Then what type of stresses acting upon the pipes from the inner side and external side also. Then how to go for the economic size of conveying main, some part we have already studied. Most of the part you have already studied into the introduction of fluid mechanics. Do you? Have you studied economic size of conveying main stresses in pipe? Studied or not? Not remember? Nobody is answering. Have you studied introduction to fluid mechanics subject?
Yes, ma'am.
Or it is?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. And in that, about Hardy Cross method, economic size of conveying main. झाले की नहीं?
ma'am.
नहीं झाला? Maybe syllabus changed. I have not seen the changed one syllabus, but it was there. Okay. Distribution reservoir. Okay. Then service storage. Distribution reservoir in the sense there are two different reservoirs. One is the GSR and second one is the ESR. GSR is the ground storage reservoir. After treatment for storage purpose, you can use the ground storage reservoir, and ESR for getting the pressure to the consumers. When you are providing the water by the gravity, not by pumping, is it possible to provide the water to the consumers by the pumping? It is quite difficult. So it will be easy to provide by the gravity, and that's why the ESR needs to be constructed. Okay, in the ESR you can pump the water from GSR. So these are the distribution reservoirs. Then service storage, then necessity, location and design requirements for the reservoirs. This much part we are going to study about the conveyance of water. Okay, now I request to copy the syllabus for the unit number 4, conveyance of water.